हैं।
सो वॉट इफ यू या यू वॉचिंग द वीडियो राइट नाउ इज अ पार्ट ऑफ अ सीरीज वेयर कोरोना इज द मेन कैरेक्टर एंड द लाइफ यू आर लिविंग राइट नाउ इज द प्लॉट विच इज प्रोड्यूस बाई डोंगली प्रोडक्शन विच इज ब्रॉट यू बाई चाइना। इन अदर वर्ड्स, वॉट इफ कोरोना वॉज अ टीवी सीरीज? लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दैट। Let's start with season 1, okay? The pilot episode, where our series starts with a really hungry dude cruising through the streets of Wuhan, searching for food and love. Wait, love? What? I have to, okay? Without the masala, people won't watch the series. Marketing, bro. He finds a bat dying of mouth cancer. He goes near the bat. The bat says with a slip of a tongue, "Eat me." And the rest is history. So you're a 12th student. I could have made you the age you actually are, but you know, teen series usually do the money. Irrespective to how shit they are. Riverdale. It's January, you're gonna graduate. So you're thinking about all the colleges you're gonna get into and fantasizing about all the college rom-com, series, movies, etc, etc. Which is never gonna come true, not because of Corona, but because they're all utter bullshit. It won't happen, okay? So you're finally thinking of studying, which you didn't do for the past 11 years. And suddenly you get a call from your Malabar Chittappa, who says, "Tambi, there's a new virus in China called Corona, it seems. It'll come to India, you're all gonna die, it seems. So be careful, okay?" The one time he is right, you don't listen to him. Because it was Malabar Chittappa, for God's sake. Who are you kidding? Then the first case hits Kerala. You think, the first case, who cares? Then slowly, episode by episode, the virus starts to increase and increase and increase, and still you don't care because you're busy studying, flirting with your girlfriend, outing with your friends and studying again. Last 5 exams of your school life. Each episode you finish an exam and come out of the exam hall with pride, okay? Then the last episode, the season finale. You're about to write the last exam of your whole damn school life. So you're excited, you have ample amount of time, so you finish your portions and finally think that you're complete and then sit in your sofa and switch on your TV. Then you get a call from your friend. He says, "Macha, exam postpone pattanagara." And you go, "What the?" Season 2 starts off with denial. You just think it'll go away, it's fake and etc, etc, etc. But spoiler alert, it doesn't. You try to get it off your head. You start playing dumb games, video calling friends for no reason, eating like every hour is your next dinner, and still are ready for your exam and the 7-day lockdown to get over. So you wait a little more. And I wait a little more. Now slowly you start getting negative thoughts. What if India becomes like China? What if your exam gets cancelled? What if I die single? What if it all gets serious? And you slowly start losing sleep. But you pull yourself together, get ready for the last day of your 7-day lockdown, wait for the day to get over, pack up your bags. Then your mom says that Narendra Modi ji is gonna give a speech today. And you go, okay, what he is gonna do? You watch Narendra Modi's speech and he says,
"Pure desh mein आज रात 12 बजे से संपूर्ण देश में संपूर्ण लॉकडाउन होने जा रहा है."
It's at this moment that we knew that we were Season 3 is when you give up and embrace the quarantine. You start having fun, start binging every possible series that your friend suggests, tries to cook, fails to cook, exercises for a day, makes a YouTube channel, becomes a news channel in your WhatsApp status, and all sorts of shit. You just can't seem to think about a life where you socialize and go out. You can't even get out of your street without getting the chills, you know? The outside world just seems like a different planet. Everything is silent now mostly. The animals are happy, Earth is happy, everyone is happy. And this lasts for 4 more episodes, then everyone gets bored and starts sneaking out. And Corona uses this chance to infect as many people as possible. Kim Jong-un dies of heart surgery. The funeral meme ironically becomes a meme. Random actors start donating, we do the clapping thing, then the lighting thing, ignore millions of WhatsApp forwards, and it slowly starts to settle down during June. But without the government orders, people start going out again. Then at the next shot, we see 2 people talking to each other at a dark area. We see one person's face in that, who is none other than the bad guy, the guy who ate the bat. Then we see a chubby person come out of the shadows. He says, "TikTok, motherfucker." Season 4 is where it all gets effed up. Kim Jong-un teams up with the bad guy, tells him that he'll rescue his girlfriend, creates a huge corona monster to end humanity once and for all except North Korea because of all the memes that we created when he died. His plan was to leave North Korea and repopulate the earth with the people of North Korea. When all this shit is happening, you're in your home sitting calmly and then you get a call. You pick up the call. It's none other than the bad guy's girlfriend. She says, "Help me," and gives you the address that she is in, where she is kidnapped, and pleads to give this to her boyfriend, the bad guy. So you write it down and try to give it to the bad guy. So you call him. He doesn't pick up. Because you don't have the bad guy's number, ra. Who are you kidding? This story should have logic. The story is all about the logic, bro. So as I was saying, Corona Monster flies into your room and kidnaps you. Because the one who kidnapped the bad guy's girlfriend was Kim Jong-un, and he figured out that the bad guy's girlfriend called you earlier. That's why you're kidnapped. When you are in your cell in North Korea, you smell something very bad. It's none other than our bad guy, who is in his cabin cooking some bad soup. So you call him, he comes, you give him the address, and a tear from his eyes roll up. He crushes the paper, puts in his pocket, and starts running. He goes out of the prison cell only to see a Kim Jong-un standing out. Kim Jong-un says, "You have one choice. You can either turn left and save your girlfriend or turn right and save humanity. You only have 20 minutes. He starts thinking. But then a thought hits up his mind. He makes his decision. With a lot of courage, he turned